Right, shall we crack on? This should finish about seven-ish. And then we'll be able to. This should finish about seven-ish. And then we'll be able to go off and watch the Champions League final, won't we? Five bits from Flynn. HJ's been to Butlins Monday. I just got back yesterday with an ear infection. No, that's not gone well, has it? Packs, 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 packs. I love packs. Like my favourite part about going to the work to catch events is recording packs. The first one is Nabil Fekir, rumoured to be moving to Liverpool. Heavily rumoured to be moving to Liverpool. Rumoured to be moving to Liverpool. And we got Axel Witsel in that pack as well. Now every pack that you open on the World Cup mode will come with a pack of equivalent value that you can then open on normal FUT. So you can see we opened a premium pack, 7.5k pack on World Cup mode, and you'll get a 7.5k pack free on normal FUT as well. Now, you won't get a World Cup pack for every pack you open on normal FUT, but occasionally you will get World Cup packs in normal FUT packs as well. No, we don't get to keep the account. Any accounts we use at Capture Events are purely development accounts on development consoles. We don't get to keep anything. I wish I got to keep 1 million FIFA points on my account. That would be lovely. But no, unfortunately we don't have that luxury. You do get a pack for every game you play, but it's a single player pack, Dino. Who's this? We've been all French so far. Kingsley Coman, 82 rated. For every game you play on the World Cup mode, whether it be online or offline in FUT, you get a one player pack that could have anyone in. So you could get someone from Tunisia, or you could get Cristiano Ronaldo in that one player pack. No, the World Cup mode is offline as well, Flynn. There is FUT, and then there is normal World Cup modes as well, both online and offline. So you'll have head to head for online with World Cup nations, and obviously online World Cup tournaments, and then you can obviously do offline World Cups as well. On Monday, I will have an offline World Cup run through for you with England. That will go live on Monday. Monday is going to be World Cup Day. Monday's going to be World Cup Day on the channel, and I think I've got four or five different packs going, four or five different packs, four or five different videos going live for you on Monday. Thank you very much for the £1 donation, James. We just sent the message. It says, "I haven't been here in a while. Nice to be back. It's nice to have you back, mate. I've not been on for a while." We got 85 rated Marquinhos, by the way, in that pack we just opened there, and Smolov. Carlos Vela has taken a bit of a pace hit in the World Cup mode. Only 79 pace on his item there. My green screen is having a little bit of a funny 5 minutes, so let me just. That should fix it. There we go. No, I'm not opening the packs live. This is the game mode isn't available until Tuesday. These packs were recorded at a capture session that I was lucky enough to be invited to at the EA offices down in Guildford a couple of weeks ago, and the embargo lifted for pack openings as of yesterday, and the embargo lifts for everything else on Monday. So on Monday from 2 p.m. UK, you'll have loads of videos from me and loads of from 2 p.m. Then at 3, 4, 5, 6, and you'll have a number of World Cup videos to watch from myself and from a number of other people as well. I am going to stream two more pack openings tomorrow. I've got about another 2.5 hours worth of pack opening footage outside of this one that I'll stream tomorrow as well. So well, you'll have another World Cup stream tomorrow, and then Monday's my birthday, so probably won't stream then. I know it has been a habit or tradition for me to stream on my birthday the past few years, but I think this year I've got family coming up to visit me because it's a big birthday, like a milestone birthday. So I won't be now. It's my first birthday. Actually, no, it's not my first birthday away from home, but my previous house, I was only about 20 minutes down the road. Now I'm about an hour and 20 minutes from home, so I'll be spending the day with family on Monday. Not the best packs that time around. Skorupski, the Polish goalkeeper, we get in that one. There isn't yet a time. Let me just quickly pause while I say that. There isn't yet a time as to when the World Cup mode will be released on console. It's not down to EA. They will have given the update because it's not an actual whole game. It's an update to the current FIFA, so it won't be a case of it going live at midnight on the store right there. If it were a new game, because it's an update, it's down to PlayStation and Xbox. So there isn't as of yet a specified time when the update will be available. Corey has tweeted out saying that once they have a specified time, if they're able to get a specified time from the Xbox and PlayStation people, that, you know, they'll let us know as soon as possible. So do make sure you follow me on Twitter. There's a link down below, and I could put a link in the chat. Make sure you follow Corey on Twitter as well. Let me find out what Corey's at is. He's one of the go-to guys. We put Corey's Twitter in the chat. Make sure you follow Corey, because he tweets out a hell of a lot with regards community stuff and just general information. So make sure you follow Corey. And then there's Gabe as well. Here we go. Gizara. Make sure you follow him as well. Make sure you follow both of these guys for as much information as possible about not just the World Cup mode, but anything to do with FIFA. And they'll be able to keep you bang up to date. But most important thing, follow all your favourite YouTubers. We all tweet about stuff as and when it's happening. The thing that got me, even like after opening packs for hours, was when you open it, oh, Koke, 85 rated Koke. When you, like, the flare is blue, and obviously it's Team of the Season time at the minute. So, and Di Maria in the same pack, that's nice. Every now and again, you just, like, say you're mid-conversation with someone, you glance back at the screen, but like, oh, blue flare, and then it's no different to the normal gold flare. I don't know as I get an icon in this particular pack, but I definitely get icons in one of the other two. I can't remember whether I get one in this one. Uruguay, centre back. Pause. It's going to be Diego Godin. Godin. 88 rated Diego Godin, who's a walkout. That's our first walkout of this particular pack opening. I do get a load. We were told that pack weight is, or was, very similar to what it's going to be like in the release at the capture event. And we were able to get stacked clubs, like absolutely stacked clubs. So, from like 12, like we had a million FIFA points, but we had stacked clubs after like 12 to 15,000 FIFA points. So it's really not going to be that expensive to get a lot of players. Obviously, there's no transfer market, so you can't go out and buy players. So you are going to have to open packs or obviously do SBCs as well. There's SBCs on the World Cup mode. And of course, you'll have to do those to get some packs as well. And like I say, you get reward packs for winning the World Cup and doing drafts and doing the SBCs and stuff. But it's easier than ever in FIFA to get a sick team without spending money. Next year, I know I've planned on doing it this year, but next year I really am going to go for it with regards to an Ultimate Team Road to Glory. I'm going to do a Road to Glory on the World Cup mode, and hopefully that does well, and it can kind of build up a smallish audience or a dedicated audience for Road to Glory style content. Right mid from Belgium. Who's that going to be? Oh, Thomas Meunier, right mid, not a right back, as he is for Paris Saint-Germain on regular foot. I can't tell you what the requirements were for the SBCs at this stage, unfortunately. It's embargoed until Wednesday, until Monday even. I will have a video going live with some SBC footage on Monday, so keep your eyes peeled for that, but I can't divulge you in that information at this stage, I'm afraid. French centre-back, Laurent Koscielny, which is a shame. Because Laurent Koscielny, unfortunately, won't be going to the World Cup. He'll be in the mode, but he won't be going to the World Cup. Oh, and Jan Vertonghen and Kieran Trippier in the same pack. That's not bad. No, the stickerbook series hasn't stopped. It will continue. I just quite simply haven't had the time to record it for ages. I do want to bring that series back. So don't worry, it hasn't finished. Not every pack is a board player, no. But most packs are board players. Most packs. Because obviously there's a much smaller there's a much smaller database, much fewer amount of players in the game, and a lot of them are 83 rated or higher. I apparently sat on this duplicate stadium for a while. Koscielny's Arsenal cruise overview, really? Do you think so? What did everyone say on Twitter with regards to your right back conundrum, TM? What's the best way to get coins? Just by playing the game, my man. Just playing games is the best way to earn coins in FIFA. There were only 5k and 7.5k packs available at the event that we went to. I believe that there will be better reward packs available, yes. But don't quote me on that. I haven't had any specific qualification at the minute. Qualification? Specification. But Heung-min Son, 83 rated, 87 pace, 85 dribbling, 84 shot. He's going to be deadly. Absolutely deadly. Not able to tell you what time the mode drops. No, unfortunately, as I mentioned this earlier, it depends on Xbox and PlayStation because it's coming out as an update and not a brand new game. They obviously submit the update to Microsoft and PlayStation. It goes through their, thank you for the host, goes through their verification process, and then it's the third party, Microsoft and Xbox, that then will set the update live. So once they have a time for us, they'll be able to give it to us, but at present they don't have a time for us. But once it's available, you'll see everybody on Twitter go absolutely mad for it, so don't worry. In this one, Isco! Another walkout, 86 rated, 91 dribbling. He's so good. It does come out on Tuesday, yes, but it won't be midnight. I can guarantee you it won't come out at midnight. It'll be at some point during the day on Tuesday. I'm 99% sure it won't be at midnight. Not all packs are board packs, no. I can't tell you anything about the gameplay until Monday, I'm afraid. It's embargoed. Pack openings only until Monday. I will be watching the Champions League final, yes. I've got the playoff final on my phone next to me, although I haven't really been watching it. I've been recording Southampton all afternoon. Can you pack badges or just kits? I believe just kits. But I might be mistaken. Don't quote me on that. 81 plus rated is boards. Is it? I genuinely hadn't noticed whilst recording or even watching it back. I genuinely hadn't paid any attention to what was and what isn't a board pack. The best card in the World Cup mode is 95 rated striker Cristiano Ronaldo. He's the highest rated pack. 95 rated. I do have gameplay that I can release on Monday. Yes, I've got SBC footage. I've got draft footage, both doing a draft and playing a draft against Matt HD Gamer. And I've got a full England World Cup run through offline on Legendary as well. Why was the actual World Cup game stopped? It's just an update to normal FIFA 18 now. So literally, everything that you would have normally paid £40 for, or maybe more, £40 to £50 for to get a full designated World Cup game is now a free update on FIFA. Which I don't think people have actually twigged and given EA credit for, but you're actually saving like £40 because it's just a free update. Argentina, left wing, not Messi, it's going to be Alejandro Gomez. Very fast, very good on the ball, but not Messi. I do pack Messi, but I can't remember what pack opening it's in. Get Lima there. Jermaine Defoe as well. I don't really know why Jermaine Defoe was in the database, but he was in this one. I did get multiple Messis and multiple Cristiano Ronaldos, yes. So it's at some point in either this stream or tomorrow's streams, I will be showing you me packing Cristiano Ronaldo and Lionel Messi. Another ball pack. French. Goalkeeper, Lloris. Oh, it's no Oh, it's Mandanda. So there's no pause. That's when you know it's a walkout, isn't it? But Mandanda's not bad. 84 rated. He's probably better in the World Cup mode than he is in normal FUT, although only 79 positioning. Vasalko as well, the right back from Croatia, he's very good. He's rock solid. This is all captured footage, yes, Nick. All of this was captured at the EA offices down in Guildford, thanks to the Game Changer programme. Very kind enough to offer me an invite, as well as another number of YouTubers from around Europe to come and record. See, that one wasn't a board pack, so this one won't have anyone rated over 81 rated, and indeed it doesn't. That's the Chadli Costil is actually the highest rated player at 80 rated there, the French goalkeeper. World Cup mode releases on Tuesday the 29th, Paolo. Tuesday the 29th. World Cup items can't be used in normal FUT, Shub, but if it's anything like 2014, they will release World Cup special items on normal FUT, and then their in-game items on the World Cup mode will receive that boost. That's how it worked last time. I haven't asked about that, personally. That wasn't anything that I actually asked about. But if you remember, you cast your mind back for the... Hang on. Belgium left mid. Oh, it's no pause. It's going to be Yannick Ferreira Carrasco, isn't it? Ah! Good player, though, Carrasco. 82 rated in the World Cup mode. Still very, very good. In fact, I used him in my draft against Matt in the video you'll see Monday. Red card for Odoi for Fulham. Oh, yeah. I literally just picked my phone up as the referee was going, red card. Do the cards discard for coins or free? No, the cards discard for coins. They discard for coins. The packs, whilst the packs aren't tradable, obviously. Oh, Bernd Leno. Thought for a moment it might have been Neuer. I don't know whether... Did he get a straight red for that? Was it a second yellow? I can understand if it was a second yellow. It was a second yellow. Yeah, I can understand that. Whilst the packs you can't trade anything, stuff does discard for coins. Because you can see I've got 1,800 coins here and I've only played one game, which was the draft game against Matt. Spoilers for Monday. Branislav Ivanovic. I would like Fulham to win, yes. They're currently still 1-0 up with 20 minutes to go. No Italian players in the World Cup in FUT. Nope. But you will be able to play as Italy in the normal World Cup mode. You can create, do a custom tournament, and I can't remember the actual number, but there are a number of teams that didn't qualify. Busquets, 87 rated. Still 40 pace. But 87 rated, Sergio Busquets. But you will be able to play as Italy or the Netherlands or any number of other teams that didn't qualify for the World Cup in the offline World Cup modes. And you might be able to play with them in the online World Cup modes as well. I might be able to give you an online run with Italy or something like that. Bale on the bench for Madrid, I think, isn't he? All the United States, yes. They just put on Oliver Norwood for Johansson. Or was that the other way around? No, yeah, Johansson's injured. You can earn packs by playing, yes. Basically, every game that you play on Ultimate Team, whether it be offline or online, like World Cup or Draft, etc. Left mid, Perisic? Yeah, you've got Perisic, 85 rated. Every game that you play on Ultimate Team, online or offline, you'll get a one player pack every single game. And then obviously with other game modes, you'll get rewards for getting to certain points in the draft or getting to certain points in the online World Cup, and then you'll have different packs available as well. I think you're most hyped for are the new game faces. There are some new game faces, yes. I'm not sure whether I'm allowed to tell you who, so I won't, just to ensure that I don't break embargo, but there are some new player faces, yes. There's no player friend in, or at least in the build that we played, there's no player friend in Ultimate Team, but there is in the normal World Cup. But as it stands, there's no player friend in Ultimate Team. At least in the build that we played. I don't know about the full release, I wasn't given that information, but in the build that we played, there was no Ultimate Team player friend. But you can play a friend and have custom tournaments with friends in the normal World Cup part of the DLC. I don't know if the new player faces will be implemented into normal FUT. I'm not sure. You'd have to ask someone on, like, Corey or Gabe on Twitter for that, I'm afraid. I don't have that information. Yeah, I'm very much looking forward to it as well, Birdie. Really looking forward to the World Cup mode coming out. CDM, Matic, maybe? Nemanja Matic, 84 rated. 87 physical. I'm not going to stream my reactions to the Champions League final. No, I'm going to be watching it whilst eating my dinner downstairs. I will do updated transfers. What I'll probably do, CJ, is... Like, do you remember last year when I did the Arsenal save? I streamed me making transfers, like, and updating the player roster. Koscielny again. I'll probably do that again. Obviously, there won't be as many transfers that are confirmed at this stage. But... when I come to build the new save, I'll make sure that I stream it so that you guys can have your input with regards to the transfers. The only confirmed transfers, obviously, not transfers that haven't yet gone through or are rumoured, but any confirmed transfers. Like, for example, Naby Keita to Liverpool. That I'll do. German, centre-back. Pause. Hummels or Boateng? Boateng. 87 rated, Jerome Boateng, for the World Cup mode. Oh, there you go. All non-qualified nations you can play with offline. Austria, Canada, Chile, China, Czech Republic, Greece, Ireland, Italy, Netherlands, New Zealand, Northern Ireland, Norway, Romania, Scotland, Turkey, USA and Wales. Thank you for that, Career Man Stars. You, for every pack you open, yes, you do get a pack for normal FUT as well. Every pack you open on the World Cup mode, you get a... I don't know whether it's tradable or untradable. I think they're tradable. I think. Don't quote me on that. I think they're tradable. For every pack you open on World Cup FUT, you get an equivalent pack on normal FUT. So it's effectively buy one, get one free. Koulibaly and Koke in the same pack. That's decent. You'll notice that I put him into the duplicate storage. I don't know whether you saw that on Twitter. Corey confirmed it and a few others have tweeted about it. But you can store... As you can put like 100 players on the transfer list in normal FUT, you can store up to 100 players in duplicate storage. England, right wing back. Walker or Trippier? Kyle Walker, 83 rated. Bosh. You can store up to 100 players in the duplicate storage. So say I packed Cristiano Ronaldo and then I packed him again. I don't have to discard him. Providing I've got space in my duplicate storage, I can then store that duplicate 95 Ronaldo and use him in an SBC. Which, of course, if one of the criteria for an SBC is an average rating, then that's really going to help, isn't it? If you can throw a 95 rated player into the... If you can throw a 95 rated player into an SBC. Oh! Literally, as I'm talking about Ronaldo, the Portuguese flag comes up, but it's not Ronaldo, it's Rui Patricio. 85 diving, 83 reflexes, 85 kicking, and 82 handling. Good keeper, but 79 positioning lets him down, really. Who do I want to win the World Cup, and who do I think will win the... Well, I want England to win the World Cup. Oh, Alexandro in the pack as well. He's very good. I want England to win the World Cup. Who do I think will win the World Cup? I kind of fancy the Germans again, to be honest. I kind of fancy the Germans again. But we'll have to wait and see. So Especially with like the emergence of Timo Werner recently. We get Yogi Loeb. Yogi Loeb in the pack, in fact. If anyone packs Lozano, discard him in advance. Thank you. You reckon Spain, do you, Foxy? I don't know about special packs in the store, Danny. I genuinely don't have that information, I'm afraid. We'll find out in due course. I'd like to think so, but we'll find out. Three flair players in that pack. Spain, centre mid, pause, Iniesta. Ah, oh. Thiago Alcantara. 88 rated, Thiago. 90 dribbling, 85 passing, still 5-star skills, I believe. Who else will be getting that one? And João Mario, who's a left mid for the World Cup mode. João Mario, a left mid. Adam Jajic in there as well. I'd like to think Daniel Ricciardo could win the Grand Prix tomorrow, yeah. I hope he does, in fact. How long's the stream? There's about another 20 minutes. About another 20 minutes, then I'm going to go and get dinner and watch the Champions League final. But I've got another 2 hours... Well, two plus hours worth of pack opening footage to stream tomorrow. Back to back, Thiago Alcantara's. Thank you very much. See, this is where the duplicate storage comes in handy. On the FIFA 14 FUT World Cup, I then have to just go and discard that Thiago because, of course, there's no transfer market. But now, I can throw that in the duplicate storage and maybe use it in an SBC. Just brilliant. I love that addition. Thiago Alcantara. So I could now use that 88 rated Thiago in an SBC and get some use out of it rather than just having to discard a duplicate, which is superb. This is recorded footage, Ash, from a World Cup capture event that I went to a couple of weeks ago down at the EA Guildford offices. So this isn't live. Hang on. Brazil, Cam. Oh, Renato Augusto. 85 rated Renato Augusto as well. I was surprised by that. But yeah, this footage is from the World Cup capture event I went to via the EA Game Changers program. They were kind enough to extend me an invite to the World Cup event, which was great. I bloody loved it! See, this is what I've got in my duplicate storage currently. And I ran out of space with my duplicate storage. Because you can only save up to 100 people in your duplicate storage, so... Then obviously they help more with SBCs. Although, you could save some lower rated ones from different nations if obviously... like specific criteria for SBCs require certain nations or certain confederations. Because of course players, rather than be listed by team... Ramos? Pique. Gerard Pique. Because obviously on normal FUT, players are sorted by team and league. But on... and Iago Aspas, who's a striker. On World Cup mode, players are sorted by confederation. So you've obviously got Europe, Africa... Is it called Oceania? I don't know if anyone from that... Well, someone from that region must have qualified. And then CONCACAF and CONMEBOL. Oh, no, so they're just part of the Asian one, aren't they? So it's Asia, Europe, Africa, CONCACAF, CONMEBOL. Centre mid, Icelandic. It has to be Gylfi. It is. 65 rated Gylfi Sigurdsson. I can only show you pack openings until Monday, Shub, but on Monday, on the YouTube channel, there will be multiple videos from various different game modes, including SBCs, draft, full World Cup footage as well. So that will be coming on Monday from 2 p.m. when the embargo lifts. Until then, it's just pack openings, but I'll have another 2 hours worth... I think we've got 2 hours 20 minutes worth of pack opening footage to bring to you on stream for tomorrow as well. So keep your eyes peeled for that. I'll definitely be streaming that tomorrow afternoon. Are these packs rigged or are you getting lucky? No, packs aren't rigged. The pack weight for the capture event was, we were told, the same, if not very similar to what it's going to be on full release. Right wing, Brazil, Willian. Hulk, obviously in the Chinese league IRL, or in, I'd say in normal FUT. He's not in normal FUT because he's in the Chinese league. We get Subasic as well as Jonas Hector and Phil Jones. Heavily photoshopped picture of Phil Jones. But Hulk will go, I'll put him in the duplicate storage there. How do you not get bored opening packs? Well, when you're just sat there opening packs, A, I love opening packs. Oh, it is 92 rated Bobby Lewandowski. Please sign for Chelsea. Thanks, mate. 92 rated Robert Lewandowski, 79 pace, 90 shot, 87 dribbling and 82 physical, as well as a decent passing stat as well. That is the highest rated pull we've gotten so far in this pack opening. 92 rated Robert Lewandowski. 4-star weak foot, 3-star skills. 92 finishing there. You can see his in-game stats. I'll just pause that for you. In-game stats from Robert Lewandowski. 80 acceleration, 79 sprint speed. So it says 77 passing on his item face, but he's actually got 88 short passing. It's only because he's got low crossing and low long passing that he's 89 ball control, 84 strength would be important as well. Obviously, you could put a hunter card or something like a chemistry style on him to help boost his pace. That's a really nice pack pull. No, the packs weren't rigged. The pack weight is the same in the build that we played at the capture event as it will be in the full World Cup mode. You will be packing higher rated players a lot more frequently in the World Cup mode than you do in normal FUT. Mainly because it just isn't, you know, the database is tiny compared to normal Ultimate Team. I can't talk about SBCs, I'm afraid, Nick. I can divulge you in more SBC information on Monday. All of the accounts we were given for the capture event, Murtha had a million FIFA points on. Although, to be fair, over the course of the entire day, well, the entire 2 days that we were there, we had 2 days of recording time. I only spent like 70 or 80,000 FIFA points. Fred, 81 rated Fred. Because we only had the 150 FIFA point packs available to us, so obviously it takes a while to get through packs. But you think, how many like great players have I packed so far, including like 92 Lewandowski and 85 rated Lauren Koscielny and players like that, 87 rated PK, we've had two Thiago Alcantaras, and I've only spent like less than 7,000 FIFA points. Like, you're going to pack sick players a lot more regularly. I don't think I can talk about how chemistry works until Monday, I'm afraid, my man. Striker for Belgium, pause. It's going to be Romelu, isn't it? Bosh. Big players all the time, man. Opening packs on the World Cup mode is going to be so much fun. We also get Sidibe and Julian Brandt in there as well, and the duplicate Kieran Gibbs. On occasion, your mic will cut out and make a lighter bong sound and come back. Really? Is that happening for everyone, or is it only Felix that is having that issue? A non-board player pack there. Right back, Zabaleta. I don't know what Meaty's rating is. I can't remember. It's happening for you as well. That's weird. I apologise. I don't know why it's doing that. It shouldn't be. I'll have to... I have to try and sort that out for tomorrow's stream. I apologise. Oh! Grr! Left wing, it's Angel Di Maria. I don't know why it keeps cutting out. I apologise. Let me just pause this quickly. Oh! Duplicate Di Maria, duplicate Alexandro in the same pack. Audio. I'm just going to fiddle with my settings briefly. The mic will cut out and then it will come back again. Bear with me. Right, I've just basically just turned my mic off and on again, and we'll see if it fixes it. If it doesn't, then I'll mess around with it for tomorrow's stream. There's still 2 minutes to be played in normal time in the FA Cup. Oh, Belgian goalkeeper. Pause, Thibaut. Bosh. 88 rated Thibaut Courtois. 91 handling. 88 reflexes. And Gundogan in the same pack as well. That's nice. That's a good pack, that. Nick with the 13 months in a row tier 2 sub, month 13, and finished my university exams today. Today's a very good day. Congratulations, Nick. Thank you for the resub as well. No, you can't sell duplicate players on the World Cup, Snesta. There is... Oh, I thought for a minute it was going to be a pause. It's not. It's going to be Vieira. There is no trade pile. There is no transfer market on the World Cup mode. You can, however, store up to 100 duplicates to then be able to reuse them in SBCs, etc. I can't play any games, I'm afraid, Vinny. Not until Monday. I can't show you in-game... Well, I can't show you anything that isn't a pack. I can't show anything that isn't pack openings until Monday. You can pack icons in the normal packs. Yes, Will. I don't know whether I do it in this one, but definitely in one of the two sessions that I'm going to show on stream tomorrow, I definitely pack icons. I can't remember who it was that I packed, but I definitely pack an icon or two. Icardi or Lewandowski? For me, Lewandowski. Who do we want to win the Champions League final? I want Real Madrid to win as well, my man. For me, Real Madrid. I would like to see the duplicate store in FIFA 19 as well, but we haven't had any confirmation that it will be in FIFA 19. Can you change offline squads? I don't know. I didn't try to. I didn't try to, Grayton. To Monoma. Nice. I didn't try to change... Change squads, but I'll be able to show you it on Monday. The England squad had like 30 players in it. Like, there's so much choice. It has a full massive list. I don't know if you'll be able to bring players in outside of the 30 man squads. Oh, I thought for a minute we were going to get Lewandowski again. I think it's been like nearly 2 weeks since I recorded these packs. So I genuinely can't remember who I got in the... Because I've not got... I think this one... I actually think this pack opening is named something. But the next ones for tomorrow are just like 1 hour packs and 1 hour packs too. So, wait and see. I know for certain I get Messi and Ronaldo and an icon in one of tomorrow's two or across tomorrow's two. Uruguay striker. Chuy Suarez, 91 rated, Luis Suarez. Lewandowski and Luis Suarez. You see, I've still not opened even 10,000 FIFA points. And the pack weight is going to be very similar. Where's my mouse? I want to pause it so you can see his stats. The pack weight is going to be very similar in normal, in when it comes out, as it was at the capture event. And I've packed, that's 292 or 290 plus rated players. Luis Suarez and Robert Lewandowski, as well as Thibaut Courtois, Thiago Alcantara twice, Lauren Koscielny twice, Alexandro, Koke. Like, we've got loads of sick players. And then obviously you get packs and players from just playing games as well, and obviously SBCs and draft and stuff. So it's really not going to take much. It's really not going to take much to fully stack out your team. Yeah, Luis Suarez is in games. 88 acceleration, 77 sprint speed. 91 finishing. 91 finishing is very good. 80 strength, 85 aggression. 99 bite. The game mode comes out on Tuesday, Will. But we're allowed to release more footage on Monday. So myself and all of the other YouTubers that were at the event we'll be able to play, not play, we'll be able to show you videos and streams of the footage we got from anything that isn't a pack opening as of 2 PM UK on Monday. Portugal, CDM. Ah! It's not Ronaldo, it's William Carvalho. I can't make any comparison between this and the 2014 World Cup mode, I'm afraid. I'm not allowed to talk about it. It'll be a title update show. A title update and a DLC World Cup mode are the same thing. Effectively. Right wing. Oh, Willian? Coutinho! Another walkout. 88 rated right wing Felipe Coutinho. And Ter Stegen in the same pack. Pack weights can be great. I'm going to absolutely... I can't wait to get stuck in with my own club to open packs. These are confirmed ratings, Joshy Boy, yes. A Fulham 1, have they? Hang on. What are we going to get in this one? Oh, goalkeeper. That's going to be Mislera, isn't it? Let me just... There are seconds to go. I've got it on my phone right now. Literally the last few moments here.
One last hope. Codger battling for it. McDonald gets his head on it. Graham's trying to keep it alive.
Smacked.
Kearney happy to...
Fulham back in the Premier League. Welcome back, Fulham. Welcome back to the Premier League. GG boys, Fulham back in the Premier League. Are you not keen on Jack Grealish? I am happy for Fulham, yeah. I can only show you pack opening footage, Shub. If the stream's laggy for you, then refresh or watch in a lower quality player. Would presume that would mean Craven Cottage will be in FIFA next year, yes, but obviously there's no confirmation of that. Oh! Mo Salah, running down the wing. 88 rated right mid Mo Salah, 93 pace, 89 dribbling. 82 shot. Mo Salah. There, here's in games. 88 finishing, 94 acceleration, 93 sprint speed. Running down the wing. All of this from less than 10k FIFA points. And the pack rate's going to be very similar, if not the same. I don't think they're planning on altering it too much for full release. So I think spending 700k on the game mode is silly. Well, it depends. If you've got 700k free and you don't mind spending it, then it's up to you, isn't it? You probably don't need to spend 700k to get... Oh, it's not a Portsmouth being Mandanda again. You probably don't need to spend... Probably don't need to spend 700k to get a fully stacked team. Duplicate Mandanda. Put that in the duplicate storage. I don't watch 4-4 tunes, mate, no. It's not guaranteed walkout, no. Every player 81 rated or higher is Mata? Jose Callejon. Every player rated 81 or higher is a board pull, though. Callejon and Mark Bartra. Two Spaniards in the same pack. The game is released on Tuesday. Yes, this is footage from the capture event that we went to a couple of weeks ago through the EA Game Changers program. Mane or Koulibaly? I'm not playing this live, it's captured footage from the event. You set up a second account for the World Cup. Yeah, go for it. I'm going to be setting up a second account to do an RTG. Brazil left back, Marcelo or Alexandro? Alexandro, duplicate Alexandro. There is no time at the minute on when the update will go out, Thiago. It all depends on when Xbox and PlayStation make it available. Get Lucas Vasquez in the pack as well. All depends on when Xbox and PlayStation make the update available. They don't yet have confirmed times, but hopefully closer to the time they will do. I'm not allowed to show SBCs today, sorry Refix. I'll have SBCs as an upload on the YouTube channel on Monday. If you don't subscribe to my YouTube channel currently, then definitely do. Loads of World Cup stuff coming. Yeah, no, if you've got coins to spend, then and like save your money and just use coins. Don't buy FIFA points. Left mid, German. Julian Draxler. Be great as a cam, it's a shame he's a wide player. I'll do the RTG on Xbox. Oh, and Douglas Costa. And Arrizabalaga. Shout out Southampton career mode. Kepa Arrizabalaga in the pack as well. Man like Arrizabalaga. Belgian. Centre back. Toby. Vincent Kompany. 84 rated Vincent Kompany. Bit slow, 61 pace. Where are the difference? You get three. I think. I actually don't know what the difference is between the 5k and the 7.5k. I think you just get three premium. All? Dries Mertens? Well, actually, no, it could be... Oh, no, it's Dries Mertens. Eden Hazard is a centre-forward for Belgium this year on the World Cup mode. 86-rated Dries Mertens. Do I show his in-games? There you go. Oh. Dries Mertens is in-games. Eden Hazard is a centre-forward for Belgium this year. So every time you see centre-forward Belgium, you're like, oh, is it? Is it? Unfortunately, this time it wasn't. How do you know who's rare? Because of the flair. 80, I think 81 rated or higher is a flair. Or no, 81 rated or higher is a board. I genuinely couldn't tell you actually what the difference is between the 5 and the 7.5k pack. What does it say on the... A mix of 13 items including at least 5 untradeable World Cup players and a guaranteed foot premium gold redeemable. Well, there you go. So one rare and three. Yeah, still one rare and three rares. I'm not sure how they differentiate between one rare and three rares. But. Like, which between a rare and a non-rare? I think that's the end of the video. It is. That was the last pack. Right. Tomorrow, I will be streaming another 2 pack openings. I just checked my folder on my PC, World Cup. I have, this one was 43 minutes, 29 seconds long. I have another one that is 1 hour and 2 minutes long, and then another one that is 1 hour and 20 minutes long. So we can open packs tomorrow afternoon as well. I'll do those tomorrow though, because right now I'm gonna go and get some dinner and then go watch the Champions League final. I am on Windows 7, mate, yes. But that's all for this one. Thank you very much for watching. Apologies it's so short. Like I say, I'll be streaming more packs tomorrow, and then full footage will be going live. Full footage will be going live of other game modes, etc., and actual gameplay on Monday on the YouTube channel. But I'll stream again tomorrow afternoon. Thank you very much for watching, boys. Enjoy the Champions League final if you're going to watch it. And I will see you next time.